Hi, and a very good evening to everyone watching me live on Instagram and Facebook. This is Marisha, CEO at The Wedding School, and it is Friday evening, and it is my time that I get to spend with all of you, get a chance to interact, get a chance to tell you what I have been up to. And it's always been my endeavor to make sure that the time that you spend with me, which is 30 important minutes of your life. Now, I am not being sarcastic. I know the big joke is that we're all free these days, but I do believe that by now we have come to accept the reality that this is the new normal, and therefore most of us have been able to identify what do we want to do in order to keep ourselves busy, you know, and using our time productively. Whether or not that amounts to us earning some big bucks, that is not really on priority for anyone currently, because I think we're all interested in just using our time well in order to keep our mental strength right, in order to be fit and keeping a vigor from within just the right amount so that we can battle with the times that are yet to come. I'm excited because today I picked a topic which is something that I had probably been sort of noticing in the last few years, but I somehow never anticipated that it's going to dissolve. The boundaries are not going to exist anymore, and it's a shift of the mind which has almost practically taken place. My topic for today is, of course, whether the hometown is giving us equal opportunities. Now, are we all at par, really? And that is a very important question that I think needs a lot of attention, because it's really important to understand the major shift that we have noticed in the last few months, with everyone practically being at a work from home experience. In spite of the lockdown curbs not being as stringent, in spite of a lot of offices having opened up, I do notice that most of the organizations have opted not to put their team through the ordeal of traveling and the risk that it carries with it. And so a lot of us who don't necessarily have to be on site have got this huge opportunity and allowance from our companies to be able to work from home. And therefore, it becomes even more important for us, especially those who are not in Bangalore, Hyderabad, or Chennai, Mumbai, Delhi. We're not belonging to this city. We're those who probably moved to one of these cities in order to make a living or in order to find an opportunity that is better than what our city can offer or our hometown can offer. And now we have gone back to our family, which most of us did, right? And now we're kind of stuck there because our parents will not allow us to come back here. And you suddenly also have a sense of realization that the beautiful, peaceful, calm experience that your hometown can give is nothing that the major city that you were living in the last few years can offer. So it's a very interesting space that you are experiencing. I'm just going to quickly say a big hello to everyone. So I'm waving back at you, everyone on Instagram, and for big hello to everyone who is here on Facebook with me. As always, I won't be taking your names, but I do see a lot of you joining in. I think it'd be nice today if you had to even share your experience of probably going back to your hometown. And what is the opportunity which probably didn't exist before, which you are now going to be encashing on, especially keeping the fact in mind that this financial year, probably, you are much better off and safer in your hometown. So do write back. I'd love to read your comments for everyone to know. Sagar saying good evening. Good evening to you, Sagar. And a big hello to everyone, to Jay Lalwani, to Raj Bahar, and so many of you over there. Hi, Payal. Good to see you here again. And for everyone else, I'm waving back at you. Surbhi is here as well. Hi, Surbhi. Long time. It's been a couple of weeks. We've not been able to catch up. I hope you're doing good. And yes, you should stay in touch. Dharani is here on Facebook. Hi, Dharani. Last time, Bhavik was here. And he did mention something very interesting, that Wedding Chance has been working on new tracks and on new concepts that you all plan to present for the fairs that you're definitely going to be called in for. So I'm really excited, and I'm sure all the planners and your clients and your friends are equally excited to know what exactly are you up to. And I tell you, Dharani, it's actually going to motivate a lot many others to use this time well, to create new content, because I think the last few years have been phenomenal for everyone who's a part of the wedding industry. I believe as planners, we are still, I don't know, call it fortunate or call it the lack of muhurts being from June to October. I think since the time we started our wedding company, we have somehow been very particular to use that 4 month slot to come up with new concepts and new themes, new ideas. And I really believe that that has really contributed towards the success of my company. But as artists, as people who run decor firms, you all don't have that lucky space, because something or the other is going on. Dharani, you do your Navratris as well. And people like you and Falguni Pathak get called months before to celebrate Navratri in other countries because they know you won't give the date on the main day. So there's something that keeps you consumed, but this lockdown has probably compelled you all to all take that time out. And I think it's great for everyone who's working on the content, because you cannot imagine the way you will be able to encash and the way you will be able to up your price in coming times, because everyone wants novelty. And if you're working towards it, it's really going to come handy. Vaibhav is here as well. Hi, Vaibhav. Oh my God, the Gujju gang is here. Dharini, Vaibhav and me. Vaibhav, I would love to hear from you because you come from Bhopal. So for everyone to know, he's one of the most accomplished actors and anchors that we have. First an anchor, and now of course he runs his own talent company. And it's interesting to watch how he has grown from this young boy who came to Mumbai from Bhopal. I think, Vaibhav, you must have tried RJing as well, if I recollect correctly. I'm not sure. But he got into the anchoring space, and a couple of years back, he started his own artist management company, and they manage Ayushman. And I'm so envious of you, you know, but you're a guy, nothing that you can do with Ayushman, but he's so adorable. Anyways, and Farhan Akhtar. So, I mean, and the unique talent, but the talent that is totally worth it is something that they managed through Canvas. So I've loved his progression from being an anchor to running his own company successfully. Vaibhav, I want you really to share with us, probably you could write back. You know, it'd be interesting to know that what brought you to Mumbai a couple of years back. And today, the situation being where everyone's accessible over phone calls, over Zoom calls, the fact that everyone has accepted this screen as the new office space, does that make you feel any differently? And do you think you can run your operations now of your organization from Bhopal as much as you can probably from Mumbai? Because it really doesn't matter. You know, I, for one, have this absolute obsession. So I stay in Chembur, but of course I'm a Bandraite, and in spite of being from Mumbai, and I think everyone who's from Mumbai will agree with me, within Mumbai itself we have this obsession about being in a particular suburb or in a particular part of the city, and that makes you a real Mumbaiite, and not just being like, you know, Chembur. So I remember I had this huge issue when I got married that I was going to leave Bandra to go to Chembur, and all my friends were from the event fraternity who largely stay in Andheri. I remember one of my very dear friends, Deepak Jagtiani, who used to joke, you know, I'll need a visa, you know, to get to that side, so I'm not coming to meet you, you know. So that kind of a mindset is something that we are going to probably laugh on in a couple of years from now, because it really is not going to matter anymore, as we are already seeing the trend being. Today you have the same opportunity in a hometown. You just need a good internet connection. You need to be excellent with your communication on that screen. So for those of you who are not comfortable with that, please warm up to it, because this is going to be a make or break for us. You are going to convert sales. You are going to improve your revenue. You're going to be discussing your new business ideas through this little screen. So this is a reality, and I don't think it's a wise thing to do, which is to take it lightly or just to take it as a momentary shift? No. We may come back to traveling as much eventually, not in the coming year or two. We may come back to physical meetings and discussions, but this reality of convenience, of effectiveness, cannot be ignored. By the time we are done with the fear and we are out there, we are definitely going to get so accustomed to be able to effectively use these platforms to be talking that we are going to do everything possible to avoid traveling for that one meeting or traveling overseas, for closing a deal. Those all major shifts are going to come into our space, and it's really important for us to therefore value the space and time we are living in and not ignore it. Weber is saying, yes, he was an RJ. See, I'm so good. I remember what my friends do. Mangesh is here as well. Hello, Mangesh. I think last time's chat was something that everyone enjoyed, Mangesh, about how it was really the event where you were working, which really led to the start of my career and forgetting my inhibitions. But I have always believed that you have to change with changing times. So guys, everyone who's back in their hometown, I think you probably are underestimating the power that you have now. You are talented. You got to just stick to your gut. Don't be in a rush to come back to the city that you probably were wanting to pursue, like your city of dreams. But understand how you can use this time well, how you can use the opportunity. And there are a lot of ways of doing that. First of all, like I mentioned, get better at using this media more effectively. Get better with your communication skills, which will mean do a lot more reading, to be able to use fewer words and being able to put your point across in a way that it registers, leaves a mark and impact, and it eventually leads into something that you really wanted to. Another thing that's really important, especially for those who were doing pretty well over here, when you came to a city which was bigger and better according to you, now you know that's not the fact, it is really important for you to understand that now that you're back in your hometown, you need to sit, evaluate what is it that organizations in the bigger cities would do differently. You need to try and get those practices into your space. Now, very simple example, you're in your hometown and you have just been informed by an organization that they're probably asking you to quit, or they've asked you to take a sabbatical and unpaid leave. It's really important, if you're looking out for an opportunity, do that in your hometown. Do not be ashamed, because it doesn't really matter anymore. The bandwidth that we are on is totally as good as what we can do in that time, right? So you got to understand that. You got to apply what you've learned of being in a big city. You've got to apply what you have understood that seems to work and why certain organizations and certain people seem to have done better than people in your hometown. Understand that differentiating factors and apply that as what we would call best practices into a smaller opportunity that you may be getting in your hometown. But I'm telling you, grab it, because it's a great time for you to actually experience what taking leadership is all about, right? You probably are still knowing a little more than the person who is from your hometown. And if you start applying this and understanding that the opportunity is as good as on that screen, you will eventually be in a win-win situation. And after a year, after 6 months, you could probably then deliberate and decide whether you want to really come back to that bigger city, or you have actually found your real calling in that hometown, where you have the advantage of having your childhood friends, you know, the street food, and family being around, and being able to switch off work at 6 p.m., which we in Bombay cannot do, even with the work from home. So it's unbelievable how much I was thrilled with the concept of a work from home. And I'd made a promise to myself that I'm going to allow my team to do that. And I think for a couple of weeks, I made sure that they all would pack up by 5:30. there are only a couple of weeks, we came back to the way we are addicted to work. But it's something very important that needs to be considered. You need to understand the entire mindset is going to shift. Keyur is your Keyur is saying boli Bandra wali. Yes, Keyur, and I am obsessed with the fact, but like I said, I'm genuinely saying this, Keyur, not anymore. I was obsessed with that fact, and now I know it doesn't really matter. And with changing times, even those from smaller cities who are probably ashamed of where they belong to, not anymore. It's changed. The world has changed. The world has literally crunched in the economic game. That's the unfortunate part. But the boundaries have blurred. And you got to understand that you are as good as what you can deliver. So it is not anymore about your address. So taking that point really seriously is going to be imperative. Whatever we're saying, for someone working on live gigs, office is where the event venue is. From back end point of view, work from home works really well. And we took no time to make that shift. You know, that was so important, Weber, to understand. I know a lot of our friends from our fraternity who never understood that point and were taking the first few months very lightly, where they thought it's all going to be back to normal from June, July, not anticipating the extent to which it's going to continue. In current times, screen is the new venue, and we have switched to the digital events too. That's right. I did see one of your posts, Weber, and it was so nice to see, you know, you're so smartly dressed. You have to see a lot of people from the corporate space. They're all suited, booted till here, and they got their shorts down there. But I like the fact that you and so many other anchors, you'll make it a point to post a full picture, okay? Just to prove that I'm not just tip-top in that space. I got my shoes on as well, and that's really important. If anyone had to shoot me now, they'd know I've done the same. So how will I use less words? The thing is, people love watching me, you know, screen time. They miss me when I'm not around, Keyur. So unlike you, I think I'm in a more fortunate space that they had been enjoying my Friday life since 2 years. And I've been very clear that I am not a creation, and my Friday lives are not a creation of COVID. I do take immense pride in the fact that I'm able to think ahead of time and understand where I want to be. But yes, of course, Keyur, I have to say this, in spite of the fact that I'm very comfortable communicating for longer hours because of my meetings with clients and the fact that I am an educator, talking for virtual events and for virtual meetings was a very different experience. It took a lot to make that mind shift more than anything. Although you may have great language, but what you need to understand is, when is it a good time to make that little shift so that the person who's receiving this information from you is not getting bored. So you don't have expressions to that you can watch out for, right? Which is very easy when you're sitting with the family for planning somebody's wedding. You're seeing the expressions, you're gauging what they're liking, what they're not. You don't have that advantage here. It was really interesting, Keyur, and thank you for being sarcastic, but you brought me to a very interesting point, which is that my way of doing it was, initially I got consumed in talking what I wanted to, and after a couple of meetings and meets, I kind of understood that as much as I'm talking, I need to listen to myself. And the minute you naturally are getting bored of your voice is when you need to understand that the person receiving it is as well. So presence of mind and wanting to improve on yourself. These are the two reasons that I have been able to mold myself. I cannot and have not ever believed that whatever I do today is really my best. I always have gone back to wanting to evaluate my work, even if it was, you know, for a pitch that I make. So wanting to constantly keep that in mind helped me understand that I got to keep hearing myself while I talk when I'm on a virtual meeting. It's crazy, Keyur. tried out, probably provided any of you are talking that much every day, which I am. So, but I like it. Val is writing, hope you're doing well. Yes, I'm doing really well. Thank you so much. Big wave out to everyone who has joined us on Instagram. And like I said, you have your hometown story. Please do tell us about that. Nikhil is asking, ma'am, abhi company ko develop kaise kare? Nikhil, main aapko bata nahi sakti ki ye lockdown aapke liye actually ek opportunity sabit ho sakta hai, kyunki जो यहाँ पर थे अपने ओहदे में, ठीक है, और जो यहाँ पे थे वो अचानक अब यहाँ पे आ गए हैं, ठीक है। यहाँ पे आप जो थे, आपको थोड़ी और मेहनत करनी है, इनको नीचे लाने में वक्त, डेस्टिनी, कोविड, चाइना, सब कुछ मिला के ये यहाँ पे आ गए हैं, राइट। सो आपको ये बात समझनी है कि अब अगर वो आपका मैचिंग पॉइंट था तो वो मैचिंग पॉइंट ही आपका ड्रॉप हो चुका है। आपको ये समझना है कि आपको खुद पे बहुत ज़्यादा मेहनत करनी है। डोंट लेट अ सिंगल डे गो बाय विदाउट यू हैविंग डन समथिंग दैट वॉज डिफरेंट एंड समथिंग दैट वॉज प्रोडक्टिव। A couple of Fridays back, I had done a session where I was urging all the freelancers and people who are not currently employed to even make a timetable, even if that means watching TV, exercising, cooking, cleaning. Put it in time slots. You will understand the gaps that you have, and that is the time you use to consume new information. I just interacted, I think about an hour back with somebody from the hotel space. Unfortunately, a lot of hoteliers have been asked to leave, and I was so impressed with just one fact. Of course, the candidate was really good, but I was so impressed with the fact that he's actually taken up a digital course already. Now, here is someone who's doing sales, belongs to the hospitality field, had nothing to do with the digital world until a few months back. And now, because he has time on his hand and no opportunity or offering, he is actually taking up a course in order to study something which he had ignored, which he had never anticipated is going to be a game changer. So use that time, use that money, and go ahead, Nikhil. Aur aap nay methods seekhiye जिससे आप अपनी कंपनी को ग्रो कर पाएंगे, जैसे कि वर्चुअल इवेंट्स, जैसा कि अभी वैभव बता रहे थे, उन्होंने वर्चुअल इवेंट्स को सीरियसली लिया है। अभी इसमें कितना कमा रहे हैं, दैट इज नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट। आप अपना टाइम प्रोडक्टिवली यूज कर रहे हैं, आप उसकी वजह से नए रिलेशनशिप्स बिल्ड करेंगे, एंड इवेंचुअली जब उसी रिलेशनशिप में किसी की शादी हो रही है, किसी का इवेंट हो रहा है, कॉर्पोरेट इवेंट हो रहा है, दे विल रिमेम्बर यू because you were available when they did not have those kind of budgets, so they were not being able to do major spends, but you gave your heart and soul. So this is a great time to make new relationships and to nurture them. I remember I had mentioned this as well, that choreographers need to reach out to planners, photographers need to reach out to planners, the way planners are trying to reach out to clients. And this is a great time because nobody had the time to listen to you before this. They avoided meeting you. Now they can't even say, "Okay, I am traveling," right? you just need to tell them I'm a Zoom call away. So, is cheese ko seriously lijiye and go ahead and do it. Keir is saying I was not being sarcastic. Ooh, okay. Keir, of course, is a great example of how he has moved on from working for events, then getting into a corporate space, and then of course starting his own company. And his wife is, of course, immensely talented, and together they make a wonderful couple and a great family. And there are neighbors whom we just don't meet. Kiran is here saying, "Good evening, ma'am." Good evening, Kiran. Nice to hear from you. And you, Sagar, you are some of the amazing examples, Palak, that I feel really proud of as to how you're taking this up really well. So everyone who's gone back to their hometown, I hope you're understanding where this opportunity can take you. Don't cease, but keep learning and keep learning. Ki wedding planner ka kaam kya hota hai? Nikhil, aap apne uncle ko bataiye ki hamare wedding school mein enrollment le le, hum zarur unko sikhayenge. But I think kabhi family member ban jana, kabhi professional banna, कभी वो कॉन्फिडेंट बनना, कभी वो एक्सपर्ट बनना, और 30-40 एजेंसियों को इकट्ठा करके एक बहुत खूबसूरत दिन बनाना, यही है वेडिंग प्लानर का काम. डिंग डिंग. सो दैट वाज माय कमर्शियल ब्रेक. ओके, नकुल इज हियर सेइंग हाय. हाय नकुल, हेलो टू यू एंड हेलो टू जय. आई सॉ जय ऑल्सो समवेयर अराउंड, बट आई थिंक आई प्रॉब्ली हैव kind of lost that. I'm dabbling between Facebook and Insta, something that again I had done before the lockdown, but now I've kind of become a pro at it. Jay Surana is here, one of my very dear students who keeps smiling, and I keep telling him ki itna bhi mat smile karo ki mujhe lage ki tum mujh pe hans rahe ho. So Jay, I hope you're practicing keeping that face a little more tight and crisp over there. I think you know, it's really unbelievable as to Jay Karmani has asked, who wants Vaha KBC? Jay, I'm sure you remember this very amazing cute team member of ours, Kainath. She won KBC, and I was unfortunately okay. So everyone here, we play this, we do these weekly meets where everybody from Team Swaha kind of comes together and one of us organizes something. You know, who says you can't keep your team bonding right? You can absolutely do it. You just got to find your ways instead of sulking. And I think we managed to do that really well from, I think, the second or third Friday itself since the lockdown. We made sure we're kind of bonding together with our team members. So we've shifted that now to a weekday because our classes have started, and my team is so committed to teaching that they refuse to come on my Friday parties, saying that the next morning we have to be there on time. So I've shifted that to Wednesday Zoom party, and Jay, it was good fun. So we played KBC, and the KBC was about different things that have happened, different events that we did. We got quizzed on which event did we do, in which order, ascending order, fastest finger first. Sweetie from our team had taken the lead to put it together, and she has been a pillar of strength. You know, when you're a small organization and everyone going back to your hometown and want to start your own, understand this. आपका उतना नाम नहीं होता है, आपको टीम को पकड़ के रखना और भी मुश्किल होता है, बिकॉज दे डोंट नो इफ यू हैव दैट विजन एंड इफ यू आर गोइंग टू मेक इट दैट बिग, एंड यू डोंट नो हाउ टू डील विद सो मेनी पीपल. बट स्वीटी इज बीन विद अस थ्रू अस बीइंग नोबडी टू अस बिकमिंग सडनली द लाइमलाइट एंड टू अस एस्टैब्लिशिंग आवरसेल्व्स. And she's so good with the creative stuff. So we played that game, and generally I'm very good at this because I'm very competitive and I want to win everything. But I don't know, this Wednesday my performance was pathetic. I barely scored a few points on KBC about my own work. So but it was good fun, and I did miss only Amitabh Bachchan's voice in the experience. Baki sab kuch tha. And like I mentioned in my story yesterday, कोई करोड़पति नहीं बना, लेकिन emotions में हम सब मालामाल. It was fun, Jay. I'm going to invite you for the next one, and I'm going to make sure that you're playing with us. Ankush Anand is saying, मजा आ गया. Okay, Ankush, that's good to know. Gautam is your, oh my God, Gautam Mehra. He's asking, how are you? I'm doing really well, Gautam. Gautam, guys, you all need to know, I don't know, he's now in a corporate space, but he is from my college, my junior, and I remember he was in awe of my sister who had won Miss India, and I had suddenly become very popular in my college because I was a Miss India sister, and then when I participated in the contest myself, I remember Gautam was studying BCom like me. But for some reason, he was very much inclined towards fashion designing, and he had designed my outfit for the talent round, and I had performed on Kaliyo Ka Chaman, and Gautam, I still have that photograph, and you will not believe, I have saved that dress. So obviously we had budget issues, and this goes back to my story, you know, hometown or no hometown, the fact that you have a crunch on opportunities, the fact that you have a crunch on money is a base for most of us guys, because that is India, right? We're a developing country, and the number of people who have these challenges is far more than the ones who are blessed with opportunities and a silver spoon. So a pair of jeans was taken away by Gautam, and he got some random things from Hill Road and he's put it across, and he made sure that he accentuates my body right. And he literally made a fantastic outfit out of nothing. And I will never ever forget what you did for me, Gautam. And I have kept that dress. And I'll someday share that little photograph with you as well. Nakul is here. He's asking, what's your take on destination weddings since a lot of resorts like us have been hit down due to lockdown? Do you think destination weddings would increase or would take a major hit? You know, Nakul, I'm not just saying this because of the fact that I'm a planner, but I am genuinely extremely optimistic about destination weddings picking up. One cannot forget the fact that you are going to be in the safest environment when you are all going to be together. The minute you're going to have a family that's going to go back to their house, dress up the next day and come back for a function, you are always going to be tensed. Your protocol of testing them is always going to be extremely extended. So it's going to be very important for us to understand the opportunity, the sense of safety and well-being that a destination can provide us. The norms, the process might get a little tedious, and I'm hoping it does because that ensures everyone's safety. But that is more from the hotel perspective. And as responsible planners, the more we insist on this from our guests, the safer we are going to keep everyone. And the minute you're into a resort, you are just going to be blessed to not worry about anything. And you're going to enjoy that moment that you want to spend with the family. So for me, destination weddings is going to be a huge scope of enjoying and feeling safe. There is extreme potential now for smaller hotels. You know, it's like the big city versus the so it's a big city versus a hometown that we're discussing, that the opportunity today for somebody in his hometown is as much. The same funda is now going to work finally for I'm so sorry, somebody's desperately calling me and I'm just trying to hang up. Okay, so the opportunity is here where boutique hotels were never ever given opportunities, you know, because it was always a big wedding and 300, 400 guests that was always on the list of people. You now have the chance of boutique weddings taking place in boutique hotels. So smaller resorts are going to be at a bigger position to gain because it's going to be the 50 pack, the 100 pack, 150 packs, which means only 75 rooms get consumed. And these are the kind of hotels that were not on priority, which will now suddenly become a priority. And this is what Nakul, you and many of us need to understand. Whatever becomes a trend now is not going to be a momentary trend. This is going to be the revolution. So you cannot just expect boutique hotels to become in demand, but they will now continue to remain in demand. There will be a new style of destination weddings where it will finally get accepted that it's going to be a different experience, but a more personalized experience with fewer people being taken for a wedding. And I think VR is going to play a very important role in helping us create the same experience for somebody who's sitting back at home enjoying that experience on Zoom or on GeoMeet. So that is going to be a huge game changer for us, that the boutique hotels are going to win, the smaller agencies are going to get picked, everyone who is meticulous with their systems and processes is going to definitely have a better chance at winning. Charu is here. Oh my God, Charu, a big hello to you. You've become such a big star. I saw your post that Sonu Nigam had mentioned about you. Charu and me, we started our careers nearly at the same time. She's a fantastic, fantastic artist, a fantastic singer. And I remember, I think it was, if I remember it correctly, it was a Viscraft event where we both met. I remember we did so many events together and we found so much comfort in each other because we were both very shy. And Charu is another wonderful success. So Charu is another amazing story of somebody who came from a hometown and has literally made it big over here. And Charu, tell me, are you here or are you back? What's your scene? Where are you in this lockdown? Megha's writing, love the backdrop. I'm extremely proud of the fact, Megha, I'm currently residing in Bandra. So it's my mom's house, guys, that I've come to. And there are a lot of pictures, and there was a photo frame here as well, but those were all her romantic poses with her wonderful husband, my lovely daddy, who is up there in heaven right now. I thought I'll become a big distraction with two amazing people behind me. You all will not want to see me, so I removed the frame. Ouch. So Megha, I'm going to let my mom know that you liked it. Kiran is writing, your Hindi, I never heard you speaking in Hindi more than 5 minutes for last 2 years. So what che ma'am, vaat evi che that har badalte samay ko apnana bahut zaruri hai Kiran ji, aur maine bhi is badalte samay ko apnate hue apni Hindi thodi behtar kar li hai, aur aane wale dinon mein main aur bhashaye seekhna chahti hu taki main aur naye logo se guftgu kar sakun. Shukriya. Megha is also agreeing with the fact. Nakul, there you have it from Megha as well. So of course everyone knows Megha Israni, the owner and director of Signature Films and Israni Photography. Megha, you'd know this more than anyone. And she writes, small weddings will increase. Yes, they will. And I tell you, it's going to be a whole new experience. When we are talking about small weddings, do not assume the scale is getting dropped. Of course, there will be weddings where the scale gets dropped, but we're talking about your what is today being termed as intimate weddings. So those are the kind of places where you're going to have everything more personalized, more amazing curated experiences, and that definitely means everyone in their hometown, look out for that opportunity in your city. You don't need to be in a huge city for that chance, because all you need to do is just get your act right. Just be good at what you're doing. Just excel. Use this time well, and you're going to see, aap kahin par bhi ho, you're just going to win it. Minnat is here. Oh my God, rockstar Minnat. How are you doing? She's writing, how do you think planners will change their pricing strategy for smaller weddings? Minnat, जहाँ तक प्राइसिंग का सवाल है, थैंक्स टू क्लाइंट्स, आई डोंट थिंक प्लानर्स विल नीड टू डू मच. क्लाइंट्स वैसे ही काफ़ी मेहनत करते हैं टू ब्रिंग डाउन अ प्लानर्स प्राइस. हियर इज द अनफॉर्चुनेट पार्ट वेयर अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स विल सी अ बूस्ट, स्मॉलर एजेंसीज विल सी अ बूस्ट. The planners who were doing some amazing work on a very large scale, they are definitely going to see a drop in business, a drop in revenues. There is no point in shying away or believing that's not going to be the case, because it's going to be extremely difficult to mold the client's mindset that they now have to finally pay a planner for the brains. A good concept, a kick-ass theme, an effective way of communicating the theme, these are going to play very important roles as far as successful weddings and creating experiences goes. But Minnat, as I have experienced in my tenure with Swaha, that it has taken a lot to create that niche for ourselves where we have been able to convince clients that you are not paying me because I'm a service provider or a coordinator. You are paying me because I bring extensive, excellent content on board. So with companies who are naturally having a bent towards that, we just need to come up with a better style of packaging, what our fees will be like. Definitely it's going to be a hit. I am not wanting to live in denial. The minute your scale drops, the minute it comes down from 400 packs to 50 packs, a lot changes. If a bride's dreams have come crushing down, I don't want to encash on this year for the money. But at the same time, it's important as planners we hold our ground and not get desperate. I understand we have teams that run on us. We have families to support. So start preparing your strategy from now. For me, the strategy is really simple. I am going to ask my worth, because virtual events means more use of brains, like I'm saying. It means more ideation, it means more uniqueness that needs to be brought in every time. And it's so difficult to get 300-400 restless people who can smartly keep their video off, do their own thing and come back, and I'm still interacting with them. So it's going to be very tricky, but there has to be a certain format which I think eventually will need to be taken lead of by one of us. And that becomes like a benchmark which ideally planners need to follow in order to make sure that you are not losing out. So, you know, that part is something that one really needs to kind of take care of. Minnat is writing back. Agree big time. I'm just going to take a minute before I read that. Hemant, if you're trying to reach me, could you call on mom's phone? I don't know why you're calling here. Okay, agree big time. I see clients get challenged to understand the management fee funda, especially for 50 packs. Yes, Minnat, that is the fact. We have been talking about that, and we're just kind of realizing that it's going to require a lot of confidence in yourself, a lot of fund management, because it's not a joke for a wedding planner to survive and keep his team intact or her team intact in these kind of difficult situations. I would also expect generosity, not in the form of donation, but some kind of respect that clients need to give us. You know, it's tough times, but that does not mean you milk on to that and take it to your advantage, because there is a lot of time and effort that's going into planning things for y'all. So Minnat is going to mean sensitizing our clients towards what we are experiencing, and also finding that one reason why you need to be paid the way you want to command. So I'm sure, Minnat, you're interacting with so many planners, and that is some bit of a concern that a lot of us may be having. I, for one, have found a huge opportunity in two amazing new businesses, and I had promised everyone that in August I'm going to talk about it, and we are stepping into August tomorrow. Not that I'm going to talk about it tomorrow, but I will be telling you all about that really soon. Anjali is here on Insta. Hi, Anjali. Hi to everyone, and a big wave. And को कैसे? Nikhil, तुम reality shows बहुत देखते हो क्या? He's asking फूफा जी को कैसे handle करे. तो You will not believe, Nikhil, आप अगर दो हफ्ते बाद आप अगर हमारे साथ लाइव में फिर से you know join कर पाएंगे, I'll be very happy. क्योंकि यही सवाल मैंने किसी से कल पूछा था, क्योंकि मेरे पास एक business idea था, और इसके बारे में मैं आपको बताऊंगी फूफा जी के बारे में दो हफ्ते बाद. तो आप प्लीज जरूर वापस आइए. Minnat is saying waiting for it. Yeah, Minnat, I'm also waiting for a day when you know, we all understand each other, and intelligence and great content gets recognized in monetary ways, just not by compliments. So compliments motivates me, but compliments can't run my organization, you know. Tushar is here. Hello Tushar. I think it was fun chatting with you. I think after so long we bonded again, and I feel so happy that this lockdown has allowed me to connect with so many people who've really influenced me in a very big way in my life. And I just feel very blessed that you know, you all have loved me so much, and in making the wedding school a big success story. And I was so touched with the kind of compliments that we got, and I'm so happy that we've had such an effective, you know, impact that we have made on the wedding industry. It's a small gesture of literally giving back to the industry that has given me so much. And for me, event industry is my world. I've spent 20 good years in this line. People with whom I had worked when I was a newcomer, when they would give me tips on what I should do. Other people that I now stand shoulder to shoulder, and I'm able to actually contribute to their companies now in the form of the talent that I'm nurturing at the wedding school. It's a wonderful, satisfying experience, and teaching the talent just helped me realize that how much of an opportunity I could garner from the situation that seemed like a lockdown. I've been able to connect with so many youngsters from different cities, girls and boys who would have never thought about meeting me, never thought about relying on me to shape their career. But today they've been able to do it simply because I took my classes on an online platform. So that live online experience has allowed a person sitting in his hometown to learn the same as somebody from Mumbai who would have come to my classroom. So it's really on you. What you decide to do at this time is going to change your game. And please accept it that that is the new normal. Like I'm saying, it's not like you won't step out, but you will be doing more work over here. So believe me, you got to give this that much of time. And I have done it, and I feel really happy at the wedding school. I've not done it alone. It's an entire team, a huge force. That has worked towards it. There are so many amazing minds that have contributed towards the way we have created the brand, towards the content that we teach. We're always exceeding our class time. So that is something I'm very proud of. That you know, we just don't get tired of teaching the students. And we had Rachna who had come in last Sunday. Tomorrow we have Vikram, and the coming Sunday we have Anchal. Who's worked on some amazing projects, you know, as somebody who's done the floral designing. So, you know, a big shout out to Rachna for a wonderful session that she took, and sexy teacher. Tushar is writing, after ages, we'll ensure we keep this moving ahead. Yes, please. I insist. Jimmy Felix is here, the rock star. Extensive, excellent content. Listening to you is such a treat, and everything you are putting forward here makes complete sense and is giving such a good clarity for us to see the times ahead and how to prepare us for the same. You're the best, Murray. thank you, Jimmy. Yes, and I truly believe, Jimmy, as artists, the minute you are able to customize kind of two sets, one which is strictly meant for virtual, and that means most of the singers have got on to singing what they would otherwise, and they've just kind of adapted. But now they will need to customize the set in a very different way, understanding the fact of what that person sitting in his home in front of your screen is actually doing, right? So it's going to be fun. And another set for smaller weddings with 50 packs, and then your main set, your third set, which is your, like, your, you know, ultimate show style, which Jimmy, you're really good at. And I do believe, Jimmy, that it's artists like you who will create that new trend. Don't get affected by the fact that there'll be other artists copying you, because that's, I guess, a reality. As much as we try to live with dignity, there are not many who hold on to theirs. But let it just be good karma, and work on that wonderful concept that you can come up with and that we all can truly enjoy. You are one of the most grounded and humble artists that I have met. And I love the fact that, you know, I always used to think that you, Neeti, Sangeet, you all are very like those pricey and hoity-toity people. So everyone knows Jimmy Felix from Asma Band. And when I was anchoring, that is the time they had come into limelight. And it was funny. We used to always cross paths at airports. They would be going to one city, I would be going to the other. I don't remember a single time when we have worked together on a project, but we would always bump into each other. And for some reason, I thought, ye Channel V ke artist hai, toh bahut attitude hoga. And then I met Jimmy. And he was such an adorable person that I couldn't believe that I had never tried to, you know, become friends with them, and they're all wonderful. I then went on to interact with Sangeet. Neeti, of course, Neeti and Shakti became very close friends. And, you know, I really believe only the ones who are very grounded, very simple, are the ones who can survive and have a career of that span. I think nearly 2 decades now, and you're still that rock star. Nitin is here again. Hi, Nitin. Copy is the new normal. So Nitin is saying copy is the new normal. Bhavik is on Insta. Bhavik, your lovely wife is on Facebook. Okay, so we say hello to each other. Nitin is saying copy is the new normal. Yes, but Nitin, I do believe that it's a short span normal. If copying is going to lead to you losing respect, you need to decide whether it's worth your time. It's definitely not worth, you know, the time, but to each his own. It doesn't take you a long way. And even if it does, the fact is you've lost friends and you've lost respect in the bargain. You need to understand and evaluate, is it worth it? The lockdown is the best example of us understanding all the money that we had, all the amazing outfits that we bought, you know, the amazing miles that we collected for a better tomorrow. We thought we were going to go out clubbing. We thought we were going to go out traveling. We saved up for holidays. And look where God has made us. Sit in our house with all that money in our accounts and not being able to do anything. So the only thing that... Alrighty, I think that is a lot for today. I seem to have exceeded my time. And before my team tells me, zip up, I'm going to sign off. So... thank you guys for spending this evening with me. It was amazing fun chatting with everyone.